Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. And today we're going to talk about the basics of orthodontic anchorage. And I know when you think people say anchorage, you're thinking like nautical stuff, but no, we're not talking about that. We're talking about anchorage in biomechanics, specifically moving teeth from one place to another, helping to provide an additional force to help direct those teeth to move one way instead of another. So here are some of the ways that we have or we use anchorage in orthodontics. So one of the more traditional ways is extraoral anchorage or headgear. And that was used, you know, maybe more in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. But we still use these now. These are called face masks. They provide anchorage to slide usually the maxilla or the maxillary teeth forward. We also would use cervical or headgear, you know, or neck gear, cervical or high pull headgear to help to direct teeth backwards or a whole upper arch backwards. In addition, you can use certain types of fixed functional appliances like a lingual arch. Let's say you had some spaces and you wanted to pull. If you just pull together, back teeth will move forward, front teeth will move back, right, into a space. But if you anchor these back units and pull against these, then everything will go from front to back instead of back to front. So that's why we use those. And the same thing also on the upper arch with a Nance or a transpalatal arch, you can do the same thing. You can get absolute anchorage so that you can slide back front teeth for overjet correction, as opposed to if you just used only chain, everything would kind of all smush up together. Instead of going from front to back, it would just smush up circumferentially. So another way that you can have orthodontic anchorage would be using like a long leg tie. So this is a long ligature tie. You're going to go ahead, twist, 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 twist. And you can take one unit and turn it into three units. It's almost like splinting, almost like a bridge where you're using multiple teeth and splinting them together. But you're doing it together with brackets and some wire, basically, orthodontic wire. And now you can pull or pit three teeth or three big teeth against a smaller tooth like a canine and slide that back. And it's just like tug of war, obviously the back teeth are going to win and the canine should slide right back without these sliding forward. So those are some of the most common orthodontic anchorage. Obviously we've got TADS too, and I'll do a separate video on TADS. It isn't something that I work too much with doctors with because it's most of my consulting is done remotely and I don't really feel that comfortable. So we kind of cut off what I'll help with at the TADS. We don't do canine exposures or TADS or jaw surgery cases, just regular straight wire orthodontics, simple stuff, elastics, things like that. So we don't really do these, but I have some experience doing them so far. You know, there's times when you absolutely have to have it. These two times right here, that's not it. But we'll talk a little bit more about that in a separate video. All right, hopefully this was helpful at understanding anchorage. And oh, I forgot to mention elastics are also a type of anchorage. Obviously not this type, but in general, class 2 or class 3. All right, thanks so much.